ओके हर्षिता, थैंक यू. व्हाट अबाउट अदर्स? समबडी एल्स टेल दी पोलार मेथड्स. व्हाट आर द पोलार मेथड्स वी हैव डिस्कस्ड? यस अदर्स,
आर जेड एंड आर जेड.
हु इज दैट? जस्ट रिपीट
मैम, फॉर पोलर एन आर जेड एंड आर जेड.
ओके, आशीष इज टेलिंग द आंसर. ओके, पोलर एन आर जेड, पोलर एन आर जेड एंड आर जेड. ओके, सो इन एन आर जेड वंस अगेन टू कैटेगरीज. व्हाट आर दोस? आशीष, व्हाट आर द टू मेथड्स ऑफ एन आर जेड इन पोलर? एन आर जेड L and another one is NRZ I.
Ma'am, we did for unipolar. We have not started for polar.
I not started polar method. Yesterday, did you attend the class yesterday?
Unipolar first method we are.
Ashish, did you attend the class yesterday? You were there in yesterday's class.
Oh no, no, yesterday I didn't attend. Sorry.
Okay, so because of that, you are telling only unipolar. Yesterday we discussed different methods of polar encoding method. So what are the other two methods? Okay, Ashish turn is over. I want others respond. Hitesh Gowda. Kavana, what are the two more methods of polar method using biphase? Yes, fast. Don't waste the time. Already 10 minutes over. What is the one more method? Okay, so I think Tina, that is done already. That is NRZ L and I, NRZ level and NRZ invert. That is over. Two more mechanism in the polar itself using biphase. Okay, biphase. What are those two more categories we have discussed? That is combination of these methods. Yes, nobody is answering. Kavana, no response. When you were there in the class, you should respond either yes or no. Kavya, I am. Kausalya. Pujita, what is the answer? What are the two more methods? Sumit, Shilpa, can somebody tell no who knows the answer?
Ma'am, Manchester and differential Manchester.
Yes. Manchester and differential Manchester. So this is something like hybrid mechanism. Okay, these two are combination of which method? Manchester is combination of, see, Manchester is combination of RZ and NRZ L, and differential Manchester is combination of RZ and NRZ I. See, whenever if there is a transition during the bit interval, so that is indicating it is using the RZ mechanism. Okay, so these are the different methods we have discussed. So we have two more methods. We'll just discuss those methods, and I will just go with one example for all the methods. Okay, so the next one is AMI. Okay, so that stands for alternate mark inversion. Just a minute. I want to do a slideshow. Okay, so the next one is alternate mark inversion, so AMI. Okay, and the other method is pseudo ternary. So we'll just discuss these two methods. So this is an these two methods are example of another category called bipolar. Okay, so yesterday whatever the methods we have discussed, those are all polar methods, and these two are bipolar methods. So how exactly these two methods are used? So it is very simple. In case of AMI, okay, so neutral zero voltage represent, so that is zero voltage represent a binary value 1. Okay, so just let me write for this. So for bit 0, so zero voltage is represented, and for bit 1, so you will be using the inversions. Each time, first time when you are using representing 1 as 0, next time it should be positive. So alternatively, we will be changing the voltage for bit 1. So binary 1 are represented by alternating positive and negative voltage. Okay. So whenever if 0 comes, so it is represented with a 0 voltage. It's something like this. If it is 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, something like this. If it is 0, it will be in 0 voltage. So next bit is 1. Okay. So consider I am starting with the positive negative voltage. Okay. So then it will come back. Next bit is 0. It will go to 0. So next bit is 1. It will go to positive voltage. Next bit is once again 1. It will go to, or bit 1 is represented with, bit 1 is represented with negative voltage. Okay, so this is called as AMI method. It is an example of bipolar. Is it clear? AMI. So if you understood AMI, next one is pseudo ternary. It is just an opposite of AMI. So it is just variation of AMI encoding called pseudo ternary, in which the one bit is encoded as 0. Okay, just reverse. Here you have made bit 0 as 0 voltage. So here you are making bit 1 as 0 voltage. Okay, and 0 is represented alternatively positive and negative voltage. Okay, done. Understood this? So that we can go for the conversion. Now consider I have data 0. 10010. Okay, so according to AMI, always when you are writing, just many of you will get confused with the rules. Okay, so just write it somewhere in the side, at the side, right side of the sheet. So 0 indicates it is bit 0 is represented with 0 voltage. Okay, I am just talking about the AMI, and bit 1 is represented with alternate positive and negative voltage. Okay, so you just observe. So bit 0 represented with 0 voltage. Next bit is 1. Okay, always instead of starting with a negative, just start with a positive. Even if you start this bit 1 as negative voltage, still it is correct. Okay, so positive voltage. Then next bit is 0, it will go to 0. Then next bit is also 0, it will continue in the 0 voltage. So next bit here, it is 1. Okay, so it should be represented with the opposite of the previous one. So the previous bit 1, it is represented with positive voltage. Now it is going with the negative voltage 0. Okay, so this is how AMI works. Similarly, pseudo ternary, it is opposite of AMI. So that is bit 1, it is represented with a 0 voltage. Then bit 0 is represented with alternate positive and negative voltage. Okay, pseudo ternary. So now just observe. So the same data, even when you are writing the answer for given data, if you are drawing the digital signal, so this is, make a practice of just putting in single line, because for same data you are going to represent with a different methods. So no need to write separate timelines and work with that. Okay, so here it is 0, so positive voltage, next bit is 1, 0 voltage, negative voltage, and next bit is 0. Okay, it is positive voltage. Here first time it is 0 is positive, and here it is negative, once again positive, negative, and 1 is represented with a 0 voltage. Okay, so this is, these two are the examples of bipolar methods. So some of the characteristics in bipolar scheme. Okay, so here bipolar scheme has same signal rate as NRZ. So whatever the signal rate, it is represented using NRZ, the same thing it is used for the AMI and pseudo ternary. So here also there is no DC component. Okay, so if somebody don't know what is DC component, just go back to the characteristics of line coding and understand. Okay. So these are the different methods. So any doubts in these methods? Thing is, you should be knowing each of the, when you are drawing the line coding or the digital signal for the given data, so you should be able to remember the important points. So let's try with some data. I think I have a question paper here. There are two question paper. I want you people to try with this data. Okay, just note down. Is it my screen is visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So if you want, take screenshot, or if you want, you just write it. Okay. So this is the data. 0. Okay. The data given, digital data is 0, 0, 1, 1. How many ones? 2, 3. 5 1 0 0. Okay, so this is the data. For this, I want everybody just apply the all the encoding methods, whatever we have discussed. Okay, in the textbook there are so many other encoding methods, don't use all those things. So those are all not part of syllabus. I am not going to discuss, just what I explained in the even syllabus also they have just given polar method, but sometimes we cannot say the person who is going to set the paper, if they ask according to the previous old syllabus, so these are all part of the syllabus. That's why you need to learn all the questions. You can just observe, this is your scheme question paper only. It is 18 scheme question paper. I will share this question paper in the drive. You can just download it. Okay, have you taken this? So now let me, I will take different data here. So we'll just try to, in the exam, the question will be given like this. Okay, sketch the signal waveform when this data to be transmit is transmit using following line coding scheme. So here, sometimes they will specify the name of the method. Okay, because if all the method, they will, most of the time they won't ask us. So RZ is asked, NRZL and Manchester encoding. Shall we try this? I want you should you should tell the answers. Actually, in this whiteboard, the color is very light. I'm just getting better in this. But here I need to create one PDF file. Okay. Let me do that in the next class onwards. Okay, so what is the data? Just take the data first. So we'll just write it here. 0 1 0 0 1 1 1 0. Okay, 0 1 0 0 1 1 0. Okay, this is my data. So now, first try to draw the axis. Okay, just write it. Always when you are attempting this question, just take the new page. Okay, then draw the timeline here. Use the scale. Okay, and how many bits are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So you need to draw the 8 intervals. Okay, and this interval should be of equal length. Okay, here when I am drawing, I may not get properly. Even I have scale, but I am not able to rotate this scale. Okay. I don't know actually. I tried so many times. It is not rotating. Just write. Okay. Let it be. So when you are drawing, you just use the scale to draw the dotted line, and it should be of same equal length. This finishes the digital to digital conversion. Next, we'll move on to analog, digital to analog conversion. If you are having notebook, parallelly you can just write it. I can just skip this part, but I want everybody should try this. This is a compulsory question for test and also for the external. Everybody should know how to draw line or encoding techniques. If you are using pencil scale, it will be easy. It will not take much time. So just count it and write here the data. So what is the data? Let me just highlight with a different color. So the data here, it is 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1. And this is also 0, I think. So we have 0 last bit. Yes. 0. Okay. So now we'll start with NRZ. You can just write it here. This is NRZ, unipolar. NRZ. So what I told in NRZ, can somebody tell? Who all know the answer? I want just reply it back soon. Okay. So that we can save the time. Okay, just I will make you to understand. So NRZ is very simple. You will be using only one level of voltage. So either it be zero or positive voltage. Okay. So how you are representing zero is, bit zero is represented with zero voltage and one is represented with a positive voltage. You just accordingly draw the timing diagram here. Okay, if I'm going wrong, you can just identify and correct me. Take some different colors. Okay, so zero is represented with zero voltage. Am I correct? For NRZ, what is the condition I told? Yes. You have not written notes?
Zero is represented with zero voltage and one with positive voltage.
Positive voltage. Okay. You just write it accordingly. So whatever the data you have here, accordingly you just write it. So if you are having notebook and pen, just try to write by yourself. Okay. So what is the next bit? Next bit is zero. Go to zero voltage. Next bit is also zero voltage, then continue. Okay. Continue. And next bit is one. So there will be a transition to positive voltage. Then once again, next bit is one. Continue. Next bit is also one. Continue. Okay. Next bit is zero. Go to the zero voltage. Okay. So this is NRZ. Next. Here only you just put line. What is the next method? What is the next method? NRZ, that is polar NRZ. Polar NRZ. In that NRZ L. So what is NRZ L tells?
0 bit is represented with positive voltage and 1 with the negative voltage.
Okay, that means you are using the different levels here. Two sides of voltage also you are using 0 and 1 is represented with negative voltage. Okay, so now according to the data, just try to draw it. 0, okay, so next bit is 1, go to negative voltage. Next bit is 0. So continue 0 voltage, next bit is 1, go to negative. So remaining 2 bits are also 1, 1, it will continue in the negative voltage, and next bit is 0, it will take a transition to the positive voltage. Okay, so this is NRZ L. Next. Others, take the notebook and try to draw it. If anybody missed the class, you can just ask the question if you are not understanding. So next we'll go with the NRZ I inversion. So here what it tells? NRZ I.
If the bit is 0, there will be no change. And if the bit is 1, there will be a change.
So change means inversion is going to happen. Okay, so no change means how we are going to start 0. Is it with the positive voltage or negative voltage?
Positive, ma'am.
Okay, it is similar to the NRZ L. Only thing is whenever the bit 1 comes, so there will be the inversion. Okay, so bit 0. So next bit is, you need to check above. What is the next bit is 1. If bit is 1, so what happens? There is an inversion. Okay, it will go to negative. Next. Next bit is 0. So there is no change. It will continue. So next bit is also 0. It will continue. So next bit is 1. There will be an inversion. Okay, whenever bit 1 comes, so you need to go for inversion. So next bit is 1, once again there will be a inversion. So next bit is 1, inversion. So next bit is 0, there will be no change. Okay, so this is NRZ I, inversion. And everybody following, no? Try to draw it by yourself along with me. I will just go with one or two more methods, then remaining you just continue. So next we'll go with the RZ. Return 0. Okay, so what RZ tells? So here you need to be very careful with respect to RZ. Okay, so that is, always there will be a transition during the bit interval. Okay, so that you need to remember. And also here we have the notation to represent. Okay, you can just observe here. So 0, you are going to represent 0 from negative voltage, and there will be a transition during bit interval itself. It will go to 0 voltage. Then if the next bit is 1, it is represented, so here negative is represented for 0 voltage and 1 is represented for the positive, and here it will go to the 0 voltage. So every bit when it goes to the particular voltage, there will be a transition to the zero voltage, that you remember. So zero, you are representing zero negative voltage and it goes to zero voltage. One, zero voltage. Okay. So next bit is zero. It will go to the negative voltage and come back to the zero. So zero voltage and one. So accordingly, you try to draw here. Okay. I'm not able to see the data. Okay. So now for R, write the time axis. Okay. The first bit is zero. We are going to represent you just to continue this interval. You have to write this as a dotted line. Okay, so now first bit is zero. So it is going for zero, you will start with negative voltage and one with positive. Okay, so just observe how I am drawing. So zero is represented with a negative voltage and it goes back to return to zero. Okay. During the bit interval itself, it will go to zero voltage. Next bit is one, it will go to positive voltage and it will come back to zero voltage. Okay, it will come back to zero voltage. What is the next bit? Next bit is zero. Okay, go back to zero voltage. So next bit is also zero, come back to negative. Zero voltage. So next bit is one, it will go to positive voltage, then zero voltage. So next bit is one, go to positive, negative, zero voltage. So next bit is also one. So your dotted lines are missing. Positive, then come back to zero voltage. So next bit is zero, go to negative voltage. Okay, so this finishes the RZ. So this is where you cannot find a sequence of ones and zeros. So whenever if there is no sequence of, can you see? You cannot find anywhere like continuously the zero voltage, constant voltage. You can just see here for representation of zero, there will be a constant voltage. Okay, here it is there for both zeros and ones. So these two methods will be facing the problem of baseline wandering and DC component. So here that is not there in case of RZ. Okay, so next continue with the Manchester. So I want anybody finished all the method, you can just put the snapshot of your notebook in the chat box. If you are using laptop, not possible. If you are using mobile phone, take the pic and put in the chat box. So next we'll move on to biphase line coding technique. So that is Manchester. So what Manchester tells. Okay, so Manchester, you need to remember the pattern. Okay, for zero will be, this is similar to, it is combination of RZ and NRZ L, and the value for zero is represented in this format. For zero you need to represent like this. For one it will be opposite of this. Okay, it is combination of RZ. When I tell RZ, during bit interval there is a transition, okay, to zero voltage, and it will be using NR NRZ L. So what is there in L? So that is to represent the voltage. So for positive you will be taking the 0 voltage and 1 for negative voltage. Okay, so we'll just consider this and you can just try to draw for this data. Okay, the first one is 0 voltage. Okay, so this is 0 voltage. So now what is the next bit? You need to check it. If it is 1, if it is 1. How will, I think I'm going wrong. Just check it. So this is 0. Okay. For 1, it will continue and it will
down. You have to continue.
Yes. So here, this is 0 voltage. So now for 1, I need to continue. Then, but still, I should get this. Okay. So I'm getting this shape, that is the reverse of Z. You can just see, just remember this to represent Manchester. Next bit. What is the next bit? Next bit is a 0. So 0 means okay. So next bit is also 0. Then you can just see it has to, it should not continue. It has to go back to the positive. Then it will go for representation of 0. Okay. So next bit is 1, it will continue in the negative voltage and it is represented the bit 1. So next bit 1, it has to go back to the negative voltage. So there will be a transition to the negative voltage. Okay, and this is bit 1. Maybe if it is little bit confusing, but you have to practice it. 0 voltage, I mean negative voltage, then represent next bit is 1. Just remember, it's very simple. I want you need to remember this pattern, that's all. Okay, so next bit is 0. So next bit is 0, it has to continue in the positive voltage and make a transition during the bit. Okay, this is Manchester. Everybody understanding, no, what I'm explaining? Abhishek, Ashish.
Yes, I'm understood.
Okay. So still maybe not everybody will be having confusion. At least try to solve 2 to 3 problems by your own. So next we'll move on to differential Manchester. Thing is, these points you need to remember. Okay. So you can just make a table. So for each of the method, just specify NRZL. NRZL, what is the characteristics? Okay, just write it here. So NRZ, if this is unipolar, then write it for polar. And what is the voltages for each bit you need to use? Just write it and prepare one table. Okay, somebody do this in your class. I want you do it and send me the table. Okay, so that everybody can make use of that. So next, you just continue with the differential Manchester. So you just use scale and put a straight line so that all the diagrams, it comes in a single page. Okay, so I'll just write the value here because I cannot go up every time. 0, 1, 0, 0. Then 111, I think so. 111, 0. Okay. Okay, so now what is differential Manchester? Differential Manchester encoding. So it is combination of once again RZ and NRZI. Okay, what we did for I, inversion in NRZ I. So if bit is 1, there is no inversion. Okay, so NRZ I, if bit is 0, no changes, it will continue. If bit is 1, there will be inversion. So accordingly, you can just draw the line coding for this diagram. Okay, so I'll just start with 0. So 0, I'm just using the concept of RZR. Okay, 0 voltage for 0. I mean, sorry, it is not 0, it is negative voltage for 0. It is represented. So now 0 is represented. So depending on the next bit. So what is the next bit? If next bit is 1, there will be a inversion. Okay, if it is 0, it will just continue. Okay, so this is 1. Next bit is 0, it will continue. Next bit is once again 0, it will continue. So now next bit is 1, there will be an inversion. So next bit is 1, once again there will be.
We have to use RZ also, no ma'am, in this.
What is RZ?
We'll have two parts. No, you have just continued it just as NRZI.
Okay, I think 0 voltage I need to consider. Yes. Okay, so 0, it has to go to 0 voltage, then it has to change. No, actually, see, we have not used that concept here. Okay, so here RZ, they have not taken that 0 voltage concept. They have taken the concept of transition. During the bit interval, there is a transition.
Yes, ma'am, but you have drawn the same line, like just as NRZI. Starting, you have done using RZ and NRZI. But after that, you have only drawn for NRZI.
Okay, listen here. So this bit is 0 means? There is no change. Okay, this is 0. So next bit is 1. Okay, so there will be a transition. So next bit is 0, there will be no change. It will continue. Okay, I got it. So it has to be make a transition here. Let me just correct it. Okay, so it came to 1. So next bit is 1. 1 means there will be, I'm only getting confused just a minute. If it is 0, no change. Okay, bit 1 means there will be a change. So you just 0, next bit is 1. So because of that, there is a transition. It will come here. So this is represented as 1. So next bit is 0. Okay, so no change, but during the bit interval, there is a transition. Okay, so next bit is 0. Actually, it has to continue. Whatever
it's wrong, I feel, ma'am.
See, if it is after next bit is 0.
Why don't it should continue, ma'am?
What? Ma'am, after that 0, 1, again, we'll get 1, right? So we have to continue, then it will go down, I feel.
The representation of 1 is different, no ma'am?
Let me just check it. So if I start with this negative, this is 0. Yes?
Better you check the PPT, ma'am. You have done yesterday for 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1.
Okay, let me just check it. Just the encoding. Okay, you can just observe. Okay, so 0 is started from here. So this is representation of 0. So then we are checking for bit 1. So if bit 1 means, next bit is 1, no inversion. Okay. So if next bit is 1 means no inversion. Okay, see here you can just observe. Let me just clarify. So this is 0. Okay, so this is 0 I am representing. Till here, okay, it's correct. So now I need to check for the next bit. Okay, so for next bit, instead of making transition, bit is next bit is 1, so it will just continue. Okay, are you getting? So next it will make a transition, it will represent 1, then it will check for the next bit. So if next bit is 0, it has to take the inversion. Maybe I have used it for 1. Okay, so 0 means inversion. So if next bit is 1, if next bit is 0, so it has to take the inversion. Okay, represent 0. Once again, if it is next bit is 0, so you need to take the inversion. So bit 1 means no change. Okay, so I made a reverse of this, just correct it. 0 and your bit, next bit is 1, so because of that it will just continue. Okay, and next bit is 1, it will just continue and it will represent the signal or the data 1. So what was the mistake I did? Maybe I think I have reversed these two. For bit 1 I made a transition. Okay, so according to this, so 0 means no change. Okay, and also 0 is represented with a negative transition and 1 is represented with a positive voltage. You can just observe the transitions. Okay, let me just correct it. Okay, so first one is correct. So now next bit is
220.
Okay, sorry. Okay, so you just complete the remaining 3 more methods for this. Okay, so I will just continue this with respect to this data. I will continue in the next class. Whatever the question I have given, assignment, I want.